I'm Sunny Gao from the Fengye Holding Group. I must first thank the committee nomination, so I have this opportunity to share with you this multifunctional composite for pipeline-defined assessment. Actually, this is over years work by my former co-work from many groups, and now they have their own group in China. They have a professor. So this actually is a many contribution from them. So this company now look in a very beautiful city of Zhuji in Zhejiang province. With the recent development of the city, they want to make an update to a smart city because of the industry 2.0 and also the 5G's development to make it realize is possible. So our company's many focus on the pipeline, underground pipeline development. So this need to develop a smart pipeline. As you know, in the newspaper, always say some problem about this pipeline because of structure failure, and they have water or oil leaked out. So they maybe make an accident like an explosion and also traffic jams. So we need in advance to know what's happening or what's the structure health. So we need the real time to monitor these structures. At the early time, actually, we have normally use the ultrasonic to detect the structure problem, like delamination or micro cracks. However, it's normally in the millimeter scale or centimeter scale, so it's maybe too late to in advance to know the structures and avoid some accident like airplane crash or something. So it's a real-time monitoring micro crack at initial stage. It's very important, and this can give us early warning of the structure problem, so we can avoid many accidents. With last 20 years of development, nanomaterial, especially some superstar material like carbon nanotube, or now it's a 2D material, they have must combine with this traditional fiber and make this hierarchical composite, what's called combine or top-down and bottom-up processing. So they can find some real application in the industry. Because they have a very good advantage about the multifunctionality of the composite. So we extensively involve all of this work our work is mainly focused on the interface of interface nanostructure. This solid A and solid B, we make a nanostructured interface. So we want to develop a multifunctional composite interface, especially electrical or optical, mechanical property, they have much different. And we can use the nano-indentation to check the stiffness contrast at the interface, and also the nano-TG or gas transition temperature, how it's changed. So we can control of this nanostructured interface in a more detailed way. So in this talk, I will focus on this multifunctionality. Very simple, on the fiber surface with skin, and also second is the composite interface. So it's a limit very small and very simple topic. At early stage, we introduced this carbon nanotube on the coating surface. We want to heal of this nanostructure defect. So this nano composite coating, they have an advantage to heal of this nanoscales defect because of, as you know, this defect have a strong effect to fiber tensile strength. the fiber rail tensile strength much lower than the theoretical strength. So this idea is actually come from this home bone structure. As you see from the nanoscale to centimeter scale, we have a multi-scale of reinforcement structures. And why the nature material have such a nanostructure direct? So Hua Jianggao gave actually in his PNS papers give a quite good explanation because at this nanostructure reinforcement, they are not very sensitive to this nanoscale defect. And also they can maximally use this plate strength. So it's after 1,000 years evaluation, they find the best structure. In our experiment, we find that even very small part, small weight percent of the CNT in the coating layer, we can find a very good and a very strong improvement about the fiber tensile strength. This the reason is because of the this coating's thickness and also the coating's marginess give a lot of contribution from the theoretical consideration. And we also develop a healing efficient factor. You can evaluate different structure, even you use a 2D material or use other reinforcement, or can use this question to give a evaluation. So our data actually is even higher than the pure CNT's fibers. So what's this effect to the fracture behavior of composite for this CNT-rich interface? So at our study, we find that even the very limited of CNT in the coating layer, they have a marginless, interface marginless is higher than the matrix, but lower than the glass. But this gradient interface have effect of fracture behavior. So you can see in this crack maybe go far away from this fiber surface. So this mean that they change the stress concentration from the fiber boundary to later on to far away or far from the fiber surface. So this is very similar like what you see at the wooden. You see the crack is a change the direction. So this behavior actually can be explained by this fracture interface equation. That means the energy release is depends on the real fracture surface. Here we use the fracture dimension to take consideration of the fracture surface. That's it's involved of much complicated or multi-scale of self-similar behavior like a fiber debonding or fiber bridging. So in this interface, you need more energy to separate it. Like when you fiber pull out from this, you need a higher interface shear strength, or you can get the interface energy release is almost double. So Professor Li Jing recently gave a good work about to develop a graphene oxide micro copper shoe. Actually can make a self-hearding of this micro crack. What he do is use this oil water interface and the graphene is on the interface area. So they can make such a micro crack. And this PU sizing have a quite easy to self-healing. But when they crack after 1 week, you can see it's almost fully recovered. So this will be given a longer service time for this composite. So next thickness topic about the electric property. Electric properties involve of if we deposit of a large tube network on the fiber surface, you see that the insulating of glass fiber become semiconducting because of their reach of physical contact of network. So they have a quite good conductivity. It's very close to the carbon nanotube only bucket paper. So this effect of this network in the composite is because of the glass fibers orientation, not this network is oriented in the composite. So along the fiber direction, we get quite a nice or quite a high conductivity, but the perpendicular fiber direction might be get 10,000s lower the conductivity in this range. So it means it's very high anisotropic electric property we can get by this fiber orientation. Use a very simple way. This is open reported data from other research. You see there is a population sharehood. Actually mean if a higher weight concentration or higher the carbon nanotube weight, you can get conductive. If lower than this, it's insulating. But by all these methods, you can break off this population sharehood. And you also can, at a very low CNT content, you can get also good conductivities. And it's follow this line, and you use this equation can describe it. A very interesting observation is about the early warning for interface. When the material is subject to a stress or stress tensor, we saw that on the polyzonite optic scope, we see this stress concentrate at this area. They maybe can break off network here and also break the matrix on the fiber itself. So this breakage might be make less material from conducting to insulating. And this jump we observe is earlier than this material failure. So we can give this is an early warning ability. We can further make use of this micro crack because it can opening and it can close if released of the force or stress. So this changement or deformation of the micro crack can make this network rebuilded. So it's when maybe I can switch on and it also can switch off. So they can provide additional information for our structure health monitoring. Besides, this interface sensor can also can give a lot of information during material processing. For example, if a polymer is the same set, the close linking, when it's finished, we can know it. And for same plastic or same crystalline plastic, you can see that this crystalline crystallization process and the resistance change can give us information about how it's in which stage. And the traditional methods, for example, DSCM, maybe cannot give any information by this way. Deposit 2D material on the fiber surface actually is very challenging because the 2D material particle is inhomogeneous. So we can make use of maybe covering effect as we delineate. We see in the our daily life that you can see that in the tip of the graphene or no, the covering particle can more deposit on the boundary because of doing the evaporation that the capillary flow will shift this inhomogeneous particle to the boundary. So they have a self-assemble and they can make a condensed or ordered structure. So all these graphene nanoparticles actually have a very wide distribution of the thickness, and also the size is also distributed very widely. By this graphene covering effect, we can get quite a nice assemble for on the fiber surface. And it's like a fish scale, as you see here. The condensed skin give us an opportunity that have the conductive fiber can be realized. And it's show a quite good conductivity compared to the CNT fibers. The use of this fiber, we find that is very good, have very sensitive to the relative humidity change under under dynamic condition. For example, when you brace it, doing your brace, you can feel that this by these fibers. And the exclusion and the inclusion, we can see the resistance change very fastly. And the seems very respond time is very fast. So this is because of the electron effect of the density, effect of the hole density on the graphene surface. Besides, because of the very thin layer of the water on the fiber, we can make use of this sensor to find the phase change temperature of this very thin layer of water. And we found that this phase change temperature is much lower than the 0 degree. So the thin layer of water seems to have an anti-icing effect. So this might be given to explain why the wooden they have to keep the water in the cell well, that is very thin layer. So they can survive until winter because no phase change involved. A very interesting topic about the colors. As you know, the nickel have this layer by layer structure. So they have reflect light, have an interference effect, so we can have a structure color what we can observe. So this, we make use of this idea to make a graphene layer and can give a one color warning effect. This was a highlight by in the Nature journal. Because at the experiment we find that the interface the colors is changed when you tensile the sample because of the structures from the thick to thinner, they were comprised of the interface nanostructure. And we also can see that the graphene, they have some crack. This doing the test, we saw that the electric property have a jump associated this crack, interface crack. Besides, we can see that the colors changed. This is follow the row, like the, from here to here. And this is predicted by our this equation. That's the increment each other very well. So as a, what we have an in progress project is about Professor Xu have find a very good color change effect according to temperatures. So we are also can deal with this reduce the HDP propylene thickness to make the transport on the installation easier because this is still too heavy. So we modify this process increment and make a very thin layer of this purple line and they can replace or the older generation of the steel underground purple line and then can give a very good environment and a very easy way to predict and give a better quality of the water. So anyway, we also do some temperature sensitively pipeline, and also we want to make this water leak sensitive pipeline, and some on the way. And also it's proposed some indoor furnitures to make it a color change. So it's will make our daily life more beautiful. So as a summary of this talk, we see that this skin of the fiber and the composite interface show multifunctionality, and the temperature, water, and the strain, crack, and the color, even the processing of the glass transition temperature, melting temperature, and crystalline crystallization, and whatever. Anyway, this all detailed by this journals can be seen. So I will finally thank the DFG for our funding the progress work, and also National Science Funding for Zhu Ji and Shaoxin from China. And we thank our former and current labor member and collaborator from both China and Germany. And thank you for your listening. If you have some business contact, you can contact the Fengye Holding Group. So because the company is targeted to deliver a product all the world and want to become number one in this problem area. And you also can contact me personally at this email. And thank you so much.